Anthony Riley, also known as Sleeping Warrior, although I prefer Anthony the Liar Riley, hasn't published a video for over a year now. He claims to be chased off of YouTube by Austin Whitsitt, Bob Nodell and Jiranism, flurfers who are even more stupid than our little Tony himself is. But he isn't gone. I sometimes run into him on other channels where he shows his infinite wisdom in the comment section. I stumbled upon Rachie's 50's channel where she presented a couple of videos that in her opinion debunks relative density disequilibrium completely. One of them is a video where a jar filled with water is falling down. In one there is a ping pong ball, in another a small rubber ducky, and in the third a nut, again attached to a spring. When stationary, the rubber ducky and the ping pong ball are at the top of the jar as could be expected. According to the RDD theory, they are in that position because their density is lower than that of the water. Because they are attached to the spring is stretched. The nut's position, on the other hand, is near the bottom of the jar, with the spring stretched again, this time from the top of the jar down. This also is explained by RDD, because the nut has a higher density than the water. Now, what happens when the jar is in free fall? Let's watch the video. What we see is the ping pong ball and the rubber ducky being pulled downward and the copper nut being pulled upward. We are dealing with several forces and accelerations. The ping pong ball has weight which acts downward. It displaces the water and creates an upward force equal to the weight of the displaced water. And we have the force of the spring that acts downward. It pulls the ball down, but it is not enough to counteract the upward buoyancy force completely. Normally, a ping pong ball will float on water with only a very small portion beneath the surface. With the spring attached, it is almost completely submerged. The moment the jar falls, the situation completely changes. The spring manages to pull the ball completely down, overcoming the buoyant force. The strength of the spring hasn't changed, so the buoyant force must have changed. In the RDD theory, this cannot happen. The buoyant force is only caused by the difference between the density of the ball and the density of the water. Neither has changed, so there must be another cause. In free fall, everything accelerates towards the ground at approximately 9.8 meters per second per second. This makes everything falling weightless, as is demonstrated multiple times in the Vomit Comet. Having no weight, the ball weighs nothing, so there is no downward force. The water in the jar has no weight either. Without weight of the water, there is no upward force. The spring, however, is not affected by falling, so the only remaining force is the downward force of the spring. Therefore, the ball goes down. Rachie draws from this demonstration the conclusion that relative density disequilibrium, in short RDD, cannot be the cause of objects floating or sinking, dependent on their density relative to the medium they are submerged in. She then draws the wrong conclusion that the Earth must be accelerating upward, which of course is nonsense. But nevertheless, it's an interesting video. This of course is unacceptable for Anthony the Liar Riley, who has made his whole YouTube career dependent on proclaiming that the only reason things go down or go up is the difference in density between the object and its surrounding medium. So he has to come up with some explanation. Being a lawyer, he tries to hide the lack of any argument behind a massive wall of words. In the meantime, tripping over his own inconsistencies. Let me just show some of the comments by Anthony Delia Riley. I let you decide for yourself whether or not this word salad can be considered to be a serious rebuttal of the claim by Reichi. About what weight is. All mass has weight, not W equals M times G, just the ordinary meaning of the word, and this weight reacts with the medium it's in. Tonley only addresses the demonstration with the nut and comes up with this. From the perspective of the guy that is not attached to that container, the nut does not move, but the container and the water in the container move around the nut. Here he's trying to go for the inertia explanation, but he ignores the ping pong ball and the rubber ducky, because that explanation doesn't work there. They move down relative to the jar. About the falling rate. The reason things fall at the same rate when you drop the container isn't even true, as far as I can tell. It only seems to do this in the first second or so. And the falling of the jar doesn't take even a second. About density, mass and weight. When asking why a balanced scale doesn't balance out when there are different masses with the same density hanging on it. Yeah, 'cause balanced scales fail to account for the volume. And the schoolies that now understand that balance arms only account for mass. Thus throwing his own density argument overboard. About cause and effect. Just because you identify a cause of an effect does not mean it's the cause with the earth. Thus throwing his whole egg experiment under the bus. About things accelerating all at the same rate. I view this as proof of a creator myself. I do agree that it is a valid question, but we have three options. Either Earth is accelerating up, gravity is pulling down, or someone set a fall rate in a vacuum, and upon discovery, you either accept there has to be a creator, or gravity is a thing, or we are accelerating upwards. It has to be the fingerprint of a creator. There is no realistic alternative. For me, mass attracting mass is totally ridiculous and devoid of evidence in support. But so is an Earth accelerating up. Both are ridiculous suggestions. He doesn't mention RDD as a possibility, thus admitting that a relative density disequilibrium isn't the cause of things falling, and he lies about there not being any supporting evidence of mass attracting mass. At the end, Flatsoid put his two cents in. Remember when I spoke about the net forces? Yes, the liquid and the gas have different amounts of force attributed based on their weight. The impulse is different. When static, they have their forces applied with difference because they have different densities. Apart from him not understanding that, when there is no velocity, there is no impulse, he changes in two consecutive sentences weight into density, thus not understanding that these are different things. And to top it off, there is Arwine, my sorry fellow countryman. How the hell is this supposed to debunk relative density disequilibrium as a force? The force disappears in free fall, but the free fall is the force being applied. Can you not see that? Thus introducing free fall as a force. Then he gets mad because Reichi doesn't react promptly and posts this. Wow, didn't even take a peek at my comment. I'm done with you, Reichi. Unsubscribed. but later on he posts another one of his gems. The combined density of the falling object is still denser than its surrounding medium. It is in disequilibrium, seeking equilibrium as it falls, thus not understanding what the demonstration is about. In my opinion, Reichy has rather convincingly shown that this whole RDD nonsense is just that, nonsense. In free fall, it suddenly disappears, although the density conditions don't change. The desperate damage control by three losers provided the necessary amusement to overcome the fact that Reichy's solution, that the Earth must be accelerating upwards, is as ridiculous as the RDD she has debunked.